بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: إن الله فرض عليكم الحج فحجوا، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي، سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وأزواجه وذرياته. It is our weekly practice to impart a dars on the ahadith of Riyadus Salihin, authored by the great Imam Allama Nawawi rahimahullahu ta'ala. The hadith that we were supposed to discuss today entails a lengthy discussion, and because we have a nikah ceremony today, I did not want to inconvenience those people who are participating in the nikah, as they may have some programs after the nikah. So just to follow the desire of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we will still continue with the dars of hadith, and discuss a hadith which is pertaining to the time we are passing through, and which is short and sweet also. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam used to prefer and like those actions which were carried out with continuity. So it is the desire of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam that whatever we do with continuity. Large quantity without continuity is not as good as small quantity with continuity. As far as faraid are concerned, as far as wajibat are concerned, the compulsory injunctions and the incumbent and necessary injunctions of our sharia is concerned, we have no choice. So one cannot say that performing two salat instead of five regularly is better than performing five times salat now and then. No, one has to perform five times salat regularly, daily. But moving away from the faraiz, from the wajibat, and coming to mustahabbat, coming to nawafil, coming to optional actions, little with continuity is better than more without continuity. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam has said, خَيْرُ الْعَمَلِ مَا دِيمَ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنْ قَلَّ.
The best action is that action which is carried out with continuity, even though it is less. So let me give you a very simple example. We have a person who recites 10 juz from the Quran on the 1st of January. He recites another 10 on the 2nd of January. Nothing on 3rd, nothing on 4th, nothing on 5th. On the 6th, he recites another 10. Nothing on 7th, on the 8th, he recites another 10. Nothing on 9th, nothing on 10th, nothing until the 20th. 20th January, he recites another 10. And nothing again until the 31st of January, he recites another 10. So in total, he has recited 60 juz. He has completed 2 Qurans. So more, but without continuity. There is no continuity that daily 10 or daily 5 or daily 4 or daily 3. And you have another person who is reciting one juz only on the 1st of January, one juz only on the 2nd of January, one juz throughout the month. So at the end of the month, he has recited 31 juz. So he has basically completed one Quran only. But this person will spiritually benefit more than the first person. It's like somebody who is suffering from an illness is told by the doctor to take 2 tablets per day after breakfast. So you have one person who is taking 2 tablets daily. And you have another person who takes 4 tablets on the first day, nothing on the second day, nothing on the third day, and 3 tablets on the fourth day, nothing for 3 more days. The first person who is regular with his 2 tablets will physically benefit more than the first person. In fact, the first person may suffer more illnesses if he is not careful. So this is the desire of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. It is for this reason whenever we have nikah after the Jummah Salat, we always carry on with our ma'mool, and if the hadith under discussion in Riyadus Salihin is easy, short and sweet, then we carry on with Riyadus Salihin. Otherwise we leave Riyadus Salihin out for the day and we mention another hadith of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and give the message. So if we really look at today's discussion, then in the introduction we have discussed one hadith of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, best amal is that which is carried out with continuity. So let's say we have somebody here who is not performing 2 rakat nafla after the Zuhr Salat. So he should resolve. And after resolving, he should say, okay, from today, I will perform 2 rakat after the Zuhr Salat, nafla, optional, but I will read it regularly. Instead of becoming emotional and waking up very early in the morning and performing 8 rakat tahajjud and 2 rakat nafal after Zuhr, 2 rakat nafal after Maghrib, and on top of 2 rakat nafal, he is performing 6 rakat nafal also, Salatul Awwabin, and 2 rakat nafal after Isha. For 30 days, 40 days, 50 days, and the fizz is gone. So it is better that a person chooses slowly, slowly, and as his spiritual stamina increases, he increases his amal also. So 2 with continuity, then slowly, slowly, okay, now I will perform the 2 rakat after Maghrib also with continuity. Then I will perform the 2 rakat after Isha with continuity. Now I will wake up for the Tahajjud as well. So slowly, slowly you build your spiritual stamina. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. The hadith that I wanted to mention, very briefly, I will just touch that hadith also. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَرَضَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْحَجَّ فَحُجُّ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made hajj compulsory upon you. Therefore, perform hajj. There are so many Muslim brothers and so many Muslim sisters upon whom Hajj has become fard, despite that they are always deferring their intention. This year the resolution is there, that next year definitely. Comes the next year definitely. And we keep deferring our intention, we keep deferring our resolve. And shaitan whispers so many different types of thoughts. This year my son is getting married, so let him settle down with his wife. I want to be there in the initial stages. I want to support them. I want to look after them. Inshallah, next year. If my son was not getting married this year, during this time, I would have definitely gone. So, inshallah, next year. Next year, something else will crop up. It's shaitan who is whispering these thoughts. So, those of us upon whom Hajj has become fard, we have the means to go to Makkah Mukarramah. We are healthy, we are fit, we have the means, financial means, to go to Makkah Mukarramah. We have the means to stay in Makkah Mukarramah during the days of Hajj. And we have the means to support our family in our absence. Then Hajj has become fard upon us. We should make sure that we go to Makkah Mukarramah as quickly as possible and absolve ourselves of this great responsibility. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has said, Buniyal Islamu ala khams. Islam is built on five pillars. Shahadati Allah ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. To bear witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's messenger. Wa iqami salah, and to establish salah. Wa itai zakah, to give zakah. Wa sawmi ramadan, to fast in the month of Ramadan. Wa hajjil bayt, and to perform hajj, hajj of baytullah. So my friends, I urge all of you, my sisters listening at home, if hajj is farz upon you, then try to go this year. Who knows, we may not live till next year. Who knows, we may not have the means next year. We may become sick. We may become bankrupt. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from every calamity of this world and the hereafter. If it is possible, please go this year. And if not, then make a firm resolution that we will go next year, inshallah. Because our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَن مَلَكَ زَادًا وَرَاحِلَةً تُبَلِّغُهُ إِلَىٰ بَيْتِ اللَّهِ. One who has the means to reach Baytullah during the days of Hajj, despite that, وَلَمْ يَحُجَّ, he does not go and perform Hajj. فَلَا عَلَيْهِ أَن يَمُوتَ يَهُودِيًّا أَوْ نَصْرَانِيًّا. Then it is up to him whether he chooses to die as a Jew or he chooses to die as a Christian. Grave warnings for those people who do not perform Hajj despite having the means. And those people who go and perform Hajj, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Hajjul Mabroor Laysa Lahu Jaza'un Illa Al-Jannah. Hajj Mabroor, the accepted Hajj, there is no reward for Hajj Mabroor except Jannah. And in another hadith, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man Hajja Lillah, one who performs Hajj only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ. And during the Hajj, he neither commits any verbal sin nor any sin by any other action. رَجَا كَيَوْمٍ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. Then when he returns from the Hajj, he returns so pure that he is as if he was born that very day. He is like a newly born child. So I urge all my friends, especially my young friends, because young friends tend to think this is whisper from shaitan, that Hajj is for old people. Hajj is for those people who resolve to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that now I want to live a life of piety. No, Hajj is for old people. Hajj is very difficult. You need strength in Hajj. So for young people, Hajj is easy. And why should you think that way? That I am not ready to follow the whole deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yet.
So I will go when I am 40, when I am 45, when I am 50, when I am 100% sure that I am going to follow the deen of Allah. No. Go with a positive view that although I have not resolved to follow the whole deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I carry out this command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and perform Hajj through the barakah and through the blessings of that place, when I return, I will be a complete changed person. And Allah will make deen easy for me. Allah will make me His friend. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant me His nearness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما صدق الله العظيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا اغفر لنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم بارك لنا فيما أعطيتنا وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت لنا اللهم بارك لهم فيما رزقتهم واغفر لهم وارحمهم اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وأغننا بفضلك عمن سواك اللهم ألف بينهما كما ألفت بين الصالحين والصالحات وألف بينهما كما ألفت بين الطيبين والطيبات ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين Have mercy upon us O Arhamur Rahimeen, forgive our sins. O the most merciful one, forgive our sins. O the most forgiving one, forgive our sins. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to follow your commands. Grant us the tawfiq to do those things which bring your pleasure. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to abstain from everything that brings your displeasure. O Arhamur Rahimeen, for as long as you keep us alive, keep us steadfast on your deen. When you take us from this world, take us with Iman, take us with the Kalima, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. O Arhamur Rahimeen, save us from the horrors and the punishment of the life hereafter. O Arhamur Rahimeen, make our reckoning easy for us. And O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us share under your throne on the day of Qiyamah. Make Pul Sirat easy for us. And O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us entry into Jannatul Firdaus. And save us all from the fire of Jahannam. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to carry out all your commands. Grant us the tawfiq to absolve ourselves of discharging the duty of performing Hajj. O Arhamur Rahimeen, all those brothers and sisters who are going for Hajj this year, grant them acceptance. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant them acceptance. Grant them acceptance. Make Hajj easy for them. Ilaha al-Alameen, those brothers who have yet to decide to go, make it easy for them and grant them the opportunity to perform Hajj. Oh, Arhamur Rahimin, grant us all the opportunity to visit the blessed places over and over again. And oh, Arhamur Rahimin, when we are to breathe our last, grant us the opportunity to breathe our last in the Haramain Sharifain. Oh, Arhamur Rahimin, grant immense barakah to the bride and the bridegroom. Oh, Arhamur Rahimin, create a very strong bond of love between the two of them. O Arhamur Rahimin, grant us a prosperous and a happy married life. And O Arhamur Rahimin, grant us them the happinesses of this world and also the happinesses of the hereafter. O Arhamur Rahimin, make this marriage a means of taqwa coming into their lives. O Arhamur Rahimin, make this nikah a means of the deen becoming complete in their lives. O Arhamur Rahimin, grant them both the tawfiq to fulfill the rights of each other. O Arhamur Rahimin, make them both the coolness of the eyes of both sides of the family. O Arhamur Rahimin, O Arhamur Rahimin, O Arhamur Rahimin, have mercy upon us and accept all our prayers. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Rabbi ighfir warham wa anta khairur rahimin. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.